within minutes, they were on their phones and the whole lodge's alarm system went off.
Tonight, the historic Timberline Lodge remains closed. A three-alarm fire late last night forced guests to evacuate into the cold. Good evening. Thanks for joining us, everybody. I'm Steve Dunn.
And I'm Deborah Knapp. The fire sparked around 9:30 last night. Inspections are underway in hopes of reopening as soon as Sunday. Ski area will reopen tomorrow. K2's Shelby Slaughter joins us live from Timberline. So, Shelby, thankfully, nobody was hurt.
Exactly. And you know what, Deb? Staff has had training for this exact scenario, and I was speaking with guests today, and they told me that the staff reacted quickly and evacuated them just as fast, and because of that, no one was hurt.
As soon as we came out, we saw embers from the roof.
Gloria and Scott Peterson were just two of the many people at Timberline Lodge when a fire broke out.
All of a sudden, we saw some employees moving very quickly, talking to each other, and we were like, something's going on.
Gloria says they evacuated immediately, and they weren't alone, saying they saw many people coming out into the cold in bathrobes and bathing suits.
It was quite an adventure. We got home last night about 2 o'clock, and we didn't know if we'd be able to get back up and get our things.
According to officials, the fire was contained around 11 p.m. Timberline spokesperson John Burton says firefighters already have a clear idea of how this fire started.
But it's suspected that it was embers from the main fireplace in the head house that ultimately ignited the roof.
Burton says the hotel is closed for the day as investigations continue. And of course, we are tracking all of the developments in this story and bring you the latest both here on air and online when we get any updates. Reporting live in government camp, I'm Shelby Slaughter, K2 News.
All right, Shelby, thank you. Want to take a closer look at some of the images that have come out since last night. Clackamas Fire shared this photo around 10:30 p.m. showing the glow of flames coming from that roof line. You can see a stream of water coming from a fire truck there in the parking lot. The pavement is bare, but there's still snow piled up in the entrance. From this angle, you can see the trucks outside and just dousing the central part of the lodge. You can see just how scary it likely was for people staying in the rooms here to the left. Now, Clackamas Fire also released these photos overnight. And check this out, showing water damage inside the lodge. You can see how wet that wood floor is. See that there? The hose lines running around the central fireplace in the back. This is part of the lodge. It's open for several stories, so any water from above would pool below.
And as we mentioned, the lodge is historic. It was built in 1937. Programs from President Roosevelt led the way for getting it built in just 15 months. He came to Oregon for the dedication. It became a National Historic Landmark in 1977. And of course, so many people know it from the 1980 movie The Shining. A lot of memories and special moments for Oregonians and people from around the world. If you were at Timberline last night and witnessed the fire, we want to see your photos or videos. You can share them. Download our K2 News app, tap on the Explore icon, then select Chime In, or you can chime in on our website at katu.com.
And again, Timberline hoping to reopen the lodge by Sunday. We'll be on your side all weekend long, working to get updates. The ski hill is expected to reopen tomorrow.